Hi there, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie and it's great to have you here. Today I want to show you how to use Padlet. And if you've never heard of Padlet, Padlet can do so many different things to organize and share work, collaborate with others. So here's a little example. Right behind me you can see here's a Padlet of someone planning their trip to Italy, where they put all this information in easy posts where they're uploading images and links, and this makes a nice attractive way to see all the different ideas that they have here. But you can use it more than just planning a trip. Maybe you're having a book study in your class and you want a place to be, everybody could share different books. Well, here's an example where they could be posting information about those novels. Maybe it's a research project where they can be posting images and text about what they're researching. Take advantage of the built-in map feature where they can be placing posts throughout the world. And then when you're ready to click on it, it pops up with the information, images that that person puts into it. A common way we use it at work is, here's an example, we had over 40 new teachers working on this Padlet the other day where we could post a question and they could all put their information, their responses on one Padlet here. So whether it be text or images, you can even link files within Padlet. So these are just some of the few things I want to show you today on how to use Padlet here on Teachers Tech. Padlet is a great place to share and curate information and collaborate with each other. Let's get started. So I'm just going to go ahead and sign up for the free Padlet account, and that's what I'm going to be demoing here today. I do want to point out you can install the Windows app. You can see when you're on the page when you can go ahead and install it. I'm just going to be showing it from working on a browser, and I am using Chrome today. But let's go ahead and create and sign up for a Padlet account, and it's very simple. So if we hit login here, you'll see right away you can have your choices where you want to log in, whether it be Google, Apple, or Microsoft, but you can create your own login too. I'm going to log in with Google here, and I'm just going to choose my account that I want to connect it with. And just like that, I'm going to have to enter my password. And just like that, we get asked, what do we want to use? You can see that you can purchase if you want more Padlets and everything. But for this demo, I'm just using the free Neon version here that allows me 3 Padlets and 20 megs of upload for free. So I'm going to hit continue. And we're ready to go creating our first Padlet. How Padlet works is like they're giving us a piece of paper and we're gonna be putting these posts on it, and then we can just drag things in, all our media, whether it be video or a file or putting those images or text in it. If we just go up to the right-hand corner here, you can see Make a Padlet. All you have to do, click on that to start your first Padlet. Now, these are some of the examples that I've showed you at the very beginning. You can see we have the map or the timeline, and you can pick any of these templates to start that help you kind of plan all the information that you're going to be putting in your Padlet. Now, I'm just going to choose wall to begin with, and I'll do a couple examples in this tutorial here today, but I'll choose wall. And just like that, it's ready to go. Now I can give it a name, and it's going to ask if it wants to give notifications or not. You can hit allow or block, depending on what you want. You can see it did give it a name already. This one is called My Funky Padlet. You can change that very quickly. So I'll just say example Padlet, just for today's tutorial. And I can give it a description if I want, icon. You can make all these adjustments in it. You can play with no icon or not, and you can just play with all these different things. And then I can hit back right up top here, and you can see the icon is here. This is the unique address link to your Padlet. And this is important because if I was gonna go ahead and share this Padlet, so if I was gonna put information, if I want other people to put information on this, this is where I can copy the Padlet URL and I can send it to them in an email and they can click on it. And depending on what I have the settings, if they are gonna allow to edit it or not, that's how they would do it. But I'll get into that a little bit later too. We have our wallpaper. I have this brick layout right now, but if I can click on it, you can see I can go from solid colors, gradients, textures, and patterns. I can choose all these different things, and you can pick whatever, maybe the theme that you're doing, go through, check them out, and you can make it as attractive as you want. You can even add your own wallpaper. For my purposes, I'm gonna leave it at this brick background here today. We have our color scheme. We have, if you wanted it to be in a different mode there for the color scheme, we have fonts. And you can go see through for posting here, display author name above each post. Do you want it to be anonymous or do you want it to show the author? So just something to think about with the post, new post position, first, last, comments. Take a look at all these different options that you have. Content filtering, this is a good one, require approval. So maybe you're using it for a class and you just wanted to check it out first before you allow it to have on the Padlet. You can check this off, and there is even a filter for profanity here. So all these different settings that you can pick when you go and start your Padlet, but you can modify these later too. I'm just gonna hit next. And at this point, you can start posting. Right before I start and create my first post on this Padlet, I just want to show you that settings are right here. So any of that information that we set up, if you click on settings, you can make the changes right through here. So if you wanted to change the name or color, you can make those adaptations there. So I'm just going to go ahead and close this. Let's create a post, and you can do this in several different ways in Padlet. Now you notice right at the bottom right-hand corner, there is a plus. I could click on this and I can start a post. So what might I want to put on this? Let's say this is going to be about dogs here. So I'm just going to write dogs. I could hit publish. As soon as I write something, I could go ahead and hit publish, but I can still add more. Maybe I want to upload a file. So if I hit the upload right here, it goes to my computer. Here's a Word document I could grab, and it's uploading that Word document. You can see how fast it's loading up through here. As it's loading up, I could be writing something about this. So maybe this is a research paper. I don't think it is, but I'll make a comment on there, and you could even put more in there. Right away, you notice I could remove this. If I hit remove, I could add a different one. I'm just gonna go ahead and change this from white, and I'll change this to blue, just like this. And let's say it's ready to publish now. So as soon as I hit publish, I have this. You can see it's in blue like I picked, but I can go ahead, I can click on this to open it. I could edit. So if I go to edit here, take a look at this. You can open the post in a new tab, copy link to post or edit the post. I could change the color if I wanted to very quickly. I like it that you can duplicate the post or you can even transfer the post. So let's say if you have a different Padlet, if there's a post that you want it to go to, you could move that to a different Padlet and you can set it as a cover and you can delete the post from here too. All right, let's look at a different way that we can go ahead and add a post. You just double click somewhere. So if I double click, we're just in kind of a wall mode here too. So this is why it's allowing me to kind of just go around and we'll put our information in. So let's put some dog pictures. So I'll just call this dog pictures. And I could go ahead to upload, again, if I had them, or I could do a search. So if I was gonna go ahead and do image search, you can see I can go ahead and search right in here, dogs, and I could hit enter, and then I get these images here. So I could go, if I wanted a GIF, I wanted a YouTube, let's just use an image right here. So I'm gonna use this one, it gets put in, and I'm gonna, so I'll write a caption this time, family of dogs, just like that. Publish. And then I have another one. I can do those same changes if I want to change the color on it. You can see how quickly you can start to populate this board. Now, a way I like to do this too, anything you can just drag onto here. So let me give you an example. So I'll just change the size here. I have a file open on my computer and some pictures. If I just go and grab an image, or it could be a file or video, if I drag it, look at this. As soon as I drag over, it gives me the same thing. So if I was going to put my dog, just like that, and we'll call this Cooper, and I could write something here, so some information if I want to, but I go ahead and hit publish, And that's another way. So you could be using the plus at the bottom, you could be double clicking somewhere, or maybe you want to just drag something over. So I'm just gonna quickly just double click on the Padlet to open up one more. I wanna point out all the different things that you can add to this. So if you go to the ellipses over here, click on more, take a look at all the different options that you can be adding. So from an audio recorder, screen recorder, location, you can add all these to your post on your Padlet. Go ahead and play with them. Everything's very, very simple. You can go ahead and actually even use a camera if you want. So if you go ahead and take a photo, if you have a camera set up, you can do that. So there I am, and I can smile and it'll take that picture of me on my camera. So not a very good picture, but hit save and you can see it gets added, and we can hit publish and we have that information just like that. So go ahead and play with some of the different things you can post. But another powerful thing with Padlet is the ability to collaborate with other people, to share your Padlet so they can add posts to you with yours. And how do you do that? That's what I want to show you next. Sharing is made super easy in Padlet. If you just go to the sharing icon right here and go ahead and click on this, you can see this is the information to share. Now, if other people have Padlet accounts, you could invite members through this right here. But a lot of times what we do, if I'm using it at work, is we just share the link. And we got to make sure that it's set the right way to have people work on it. So under secret, which it is right now, it says keep the Padlet hidden from the public. If I choose to share it with someone, they should be able to access it. So visitors can write to this. I can change that privacy by just clicking on it. And you can see if you just want to make sure that it's private, that no one will be able to see it or work on it with you. We have a password protect it, or we can let the whole world down here see it if we turn it to public. You get a couple more options here with the logged in visitors only or visitor permissions. What do you want them to do? Can read, can write, or can edit? So make sure you have these settings, go through them depending on how you want people to be collaborating with you on your Padlet here. And so once you get, let's say if I'm keeping it as secret here, I can go ahead and hit copy to clipboard, and then I can send that and paste it in an email and send it out to people. A cool feature is if I click QR code, I could get this QR code and then I could put it somewhere, copy, paste it somewhere, and then I could just put it, and then they could just join the Padlet by using their mobile device. We can embed it in a website, we could email it, share it on social media, and we can even export it as an image, as a PDF. You can see all the different options, and I can even print it. So there's many ways to share your Padlet. So if everything is set up the way you want and you wanted to share it, a lot of times we just copy the link and send it out, but then you can find the best way that works for you. So if you ever want to see how many Padlets you can still create under your free account or see what's in your drive, go ahead and just click on your user menu. And you can see I've used one of three here, and I have some options through here. I can go ahead and open up my drive. The drive is the information, so the files and the pictures that I've uploaded to Padlet, and that's being saved there. Remember, you have 20 megs. When I close that, it just went back to this screen. So just navigating this, if I'm on this, if I hit my profile name here and I go to home, it will bring me back to that window too. Another way you can do this, if I'm in the Padlet, if I just click on Padlet up here, it will bring it back too. So just some different ways to navigate. You can see right through here that I have the option. This is where my Padlet's getting saved, and I have three that I can create. Whenever you see these three little dots, the ellipses, you can find more information. If I want to delete this, copy link, I could add a bookmark if I'm, you know, getting lots of Padlets in here that if I have maybe paid for, and I can even have more. So it can get pretty busy with Padlets. But I just want to finish this with kind of showing you different types of Padlets that I showed you at the beginning. Now, I showed you from the gallery. So if I go to the gallery, what you're going to be able to see is what other people have created. And that's what I was giving you a few examples here. So you can take a look at the gallery and you can copy the link or add a bookmark to any of these. So I was opening up these ones, and then you're going to have some options depending on what people have set it for. But take a look, you can remake it. If I go ahead and hit remake, then I can copy that design over and then maybe make some changes after that. But I wouldn't be able to, unless they've given me write permission, I can't go ahead and double click on this because I don't have the permissions to change anything to add any post to this. So if I just close this one, I want to point out when we go make a Padlet, the options that I've showed you before. So if we were, for example, going to a timeline and I just select that one, nothing really changes on how you do anything. So I can go ahead and name it. I'm just going to hit next here and start posting. This works the same way. Even in timeline mode, I could double click and I'm going to get the post to put, and that's where I put the information. Everything works the same way. So whether you're using maybe a timeline or you're using a map, you're going to see that everything's going to work the same way. When you're using the map, you can go ahead and find a spot here. So if there was a spot you wanted to go to, then you could do your plus. And this is where you can search for maybe a name here. So it doesn't have to be the double click. You can search for the name. So if I was looking for New York, you can see that it will find it. Then I can get the information, do the same stuff that I did before. I'm just going to hit publish, and you can see that it's added the marker on the map. So different ways to create these Padlets. Remember the different sharing possibilities with it and all the different things that you can do to how to use Padlet. It's a great tool to use for sharing from in school to be using it, or even in the workplace like we do to be able to collaborate with. So I hope you like this video on how to use Padlet. Hopefully it works for you. Let me know in the comments down below if this does, or else if you want to know something else about it. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.